أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم صل وسلم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. Today inshallah is to talk about the izza, the honor of this deen, and the honor to be in this deen. And that without this deen, there is no izza, there is no honor. Because the honor, it's with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-izzatu lillah wahda. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, man kana yuridu al-izza, whoever wants the honor, al-izza, that's one of the explanation of al-izza. فَلِلَّهِ الْعِزَّةُ جَمِيعًا. Allah owns all of it. Allah has all of it. And as well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, الَّذِينَ يَتَّخِذُونَ الْكَافِرِينَ أَوْلِيَاءَ مِنْ دُونِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. Those that take friends and protectors, people other than the believers, أَيَبْتَغُونَ عِنْدَهُمُ الْعِزَّةِ. Do those people that take protection in other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, other than mu'mineen, do they want from them al-izzah? So this is in the Quran, Allah is asking them. فَإِنَّ الْعِزَّةَ لِلَّهِ جَمِيعًا. If that's what they're after, then izzah, the honor and the protection and everything, it's with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All of it is with Allah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said as well in another ayah, سُبْحَانَ رَبِّكَ رَبِّ الْعِزَّةِ عَمَّا يَصِفُونَ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He made al-izzah to Him and Him alone. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says as well, وَلِلَّهِ الْعِزَّةُ وَلِرَسُولِهِ وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. This honor belongs to Allah and to His Rasul and to the believers. So the izzah, it is for Allah, it belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whoever makes a connection with Allah, then the izzah transfers to him. The honor and izzah transfers to the one that makes the connection, to the one that has it. So here, we subhanallah, we find this in Islam. The deen, this deen of ours, is the one that has it because it is the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's the deen of Allah. Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu, he said, نَحْنُ قَوْمٌ أَعَزَّنَ اللَّهُ بِالْإِسْلَامِ. We are people that Allah has raised us and gave us honor with this deen, with the deen, with the Islam. It doesn't matter where we're going to look for it, it will not be there. And if we look for the izzah and honor and rank and other than this, he said, أَذَلَّنَ اللَّهُ. Allah, he said, Allah will humiliate us. Allah will humiliate us. So, if we're seeking izzah and honor and positions, and it is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It belongs to Allah, it belongs to His deen. That's what it is. It's with His deen. And whoever is looking for it somewhere else, he will not find it. Not only that, he will be humiliated. He will be humiliated. So it's this with this deen that subhanAllah, a human being get raised ranks and being respected. It's with this deen. This deen that liberated us from worshipping any other thing than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to worship the Creator. And like we said, the ayah said, وَلِلَّهِ الْعِزَّةُ وَلِرَسُولِهِ وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whoever connects with Him, it will transfer to everybody, to Him and to everybody around Him. And subhanAllah, I was just looking at by accident on the news, I don't know if you saw it or not, but subhanAllah, there was this, they found this boxer. This boxer, in subhanAllah, nowhere, when the camera showed him, he was in a ruggedy van, broken down van, filth all around the van, where? In Bulgaria. from all places. They found this man, although obviously he's about 73 years old, he's a boxer. Because he boxed Muhammad Ali. He boxed Muhammad Ali, he boxed the greatest. And subhanAllah, somebody found him there, I don't know how they did find him, but they found out that he is a boxer that boxed the greatest. So they went around and they did GoFundMe for him. You know, they do this little whatever app or whatever they do, that they gather money fundraising for him. And here is the, I can't remember the name of him, but here is this man that is a boxer, he boxed against the greatest, this and that. So they got him, I think, like 15,000 or 20,000 in a new van and all the rest of it. And I said, subhanAllah, this man is not a Muslim, okay? But he was related to somebody that is Muslim. And we all know Muhammad Ali, rahimahullah, may Allah have mercy on his soul. This man, mashallah, wherever he was always connected with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everything they ask him a question, he brings Allah into it. Ask him about a bodyguard, he brings Allah into it, that subhanAllah. And as you know, while he was alive, they wanted to give him a star, those Hollywood stars. That they walk, you know, the stars that they have in Hollywood. And he turned around to them and he said to them, I don't want my name. My name belongs to the greatest, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he told them, I don't want this name to be walked on. I don't want a star. So they were cut, they said to him, okay, we will give you a star and we'll hang it on in a wall, not on the ground. And he accepted when they did that, subhanAllah. He's raising this Islam, this deen. And with his love of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he's the only one that has it on the wall. Only one that has a star on the wall and nobody can spit on it or walk on it or anything. So this man, subhanAllah, I'm watching, I said, just because this man was so, subhanAllah, connected with Allah, and we all know the khatima of Muhammad Ali, rahimahullah, and even though after his death, it's still raising in ranks, he still have the izzah and the honor, apparently an airport in whatever it is, Kentucky, I think, or somewhere, is going to be named after him. He's there. And yet, an airport is going to be named after him, subhanAllah. This is how, because he was connected to Allah, because he raised this deen, he wasn't no sheikh, he wasn't no hafiz, he wasn't nobody that you would say, mashallah, the taqwa, but the man has belief, he has integrity, had ikhlas with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah raised him while he was alive, raised him, still raising him while he's dead. And not only that, anybody that associated himself with him got the izzah, got the honor. Like I said, I'm watching this man, it was last week or this week. A man like in all this is happening because he boxed Muhammad Ali. That's what he got the fame from. So that's what, subhanAllah, this honor that Allah gives you because of whatever a person is doing. And it's only Allah knows what that person is doing. And it's got nothing to do with the way he looks or the way he is or how rich he is. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the hadith al-Qudsi summons Jibreel alayhi salam and he tells him, Ya Jibreel, I love Fulan. Love him. So for somebody to reach this rank and to be raised, to be mentioned in the Mala al-A'la, and then that love transfers to all the living that dwells in the whole skies, in the whole heavens, the seven heavens, they love that person. And then the love comes down right to him, and whoever sees him, love him. Subhanallah. Because that's the pure love that comes down from the heavens. This here, not everybody reaches. It is a high rank to be reached. For a name to be mentioned in al-Mala al-A'la, wallahi, this takes a lot of ikhlas. That's why all this honor that we are seeking belongs to Islam, to this deen. If we are in the right path, doing what's right, and being an example of a Muslim, that's what raises us. That is what raises us. So here, the more we reach this izzah and honor with the obedience to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to get closer to Allah. We lose it if we are in a disobedience and we are far from Allah. There is no honor and no izzah if we are far from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this here, it's for mu'mineen. Mu'mineen billahi subhanahu, the one that believes in Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَلَا تَهِنُوا وَلَا تَحْزَنُوا وَأَنْتُمُ الْأَعْلَوْنَ إِن كُنْتُمْ مُؤْمِنِينَ. He said, don't worry. Don't mind things. You are the highest. You are the top. If you are believers. So no matter what happens to us, no matter what goes around us, if we stick to this deen, if we stick to this deen, we will be raised in honor. Our honor and izzah will be raised with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says, Allah waliyu alladhina amanu yukhrijuhum min adh-dhulumati ila an-nur. Allah is the protector. He's the defender. He's the one that the mu'mineen belongs to. If we're mu'mineen, if we're believers, we belong to Allah. Allah is our protector, is our master. Allah waliyu alladhina amanu. He will take us from the darkness and will put us in light. He will take us from the darkness and he will let us know the reality of things, what really it means. Because when you look at things with glasses, with the Quran glasses, it's different. Things are really clear. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّ اللَّهَ مَوْلَى الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَأَنَّ الْكَافِرِينَ لَا مَوْلَى لَهُمْ. Allah is the master of those that believe, and those that disbelieve have no master. Have no master. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, إِنَّا لَنَنْصُرُ رُسُولَنَا وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. This is a promise from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to us, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will give victory to his messengers and to those that believe. This is a promise of Allah to us. If we stick to the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will make us victorious in this dunya. Allah says in the Quran, fi al-hayati dunya. While you are alive, while you're still breathing, Allah will give you victory. And وَيَوْمَ يَقُومُ الْأَشْهَادُ. The day will really need to be victorious. He's saying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this life and in the hereafter. Allah will make us victorious. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us victorious in this dunya and in the akhirah. Ameen. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us, forgive our sins and our shortcomings. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us Jannah, Jannatul Firdaus, without fire punishment. Ameen.